In this tutorial, I continue to vectorize a pencil drawing. My name is André Kröger from Dagubi. Today, I'll show you how to create the letter D in Adobe Illustrator. The first thing I need is the basic shape of the letter O. So I copy this shape. And paste it into a new layer. So I do that to choose paste in place. And now move the shape to the right. So next, choose the group selection tool and select all inner paths. Select and delete the path and remove all colors. Oh, sorry, select shape. So next, choose the direct selection tool and select only these 4 points. So next, cut these points, go to the top toolbar and click on this button. Cut path at selected anchor points and delete with the group selection tool, select these two paths and delete the path. And now apply black color and change the stroke wire to very thin. So next, choose rectangle tool and create a rectangle. So by the way, it's important to enable the smart guys and snap to point. So now go and create a rectangle. So start here on the left side and snap to the right shape. So next, scale this rectangle and now it's important to move this rectangle. So choose the selection tool and select both shapes. And now it's very important to define this shape as a key object. So if both paths are selected and you choose, you work with the selection tool, click on this path. And now you can see this is your key object. And click on this button, Vertical Align Center. So next, we need three shapes for that one. So you can see this a compound path. So please go to Object, Compound Path, and click on Release. So we need copy of this path and move this to the left. So next, select these three shapes and open the Pathfinder and click on this button, Unite. So next, I'm going to create a second rectangle. So So now again choose a selection tool and select both rectangles. And now click on the big rectangle to define it as a key object. And click on this button, Vertical Align Center. So next choose the group selection tool, zoom in and move this path to the left. And it's very important to hold the shift key for horizontal line. And snap to the rectangle. So now select both shapes and open the Pathfinder, and this time click on this button minus front. But it's important to arrange your layers. You have to move this path over the rectangle. Now again select both paths and click on minus front. So next choose the direct selection tool, select the left side of the big rectangle and move this to the left, to the right, and every time you move these points hold shift for a perfect horizontal line. And next the right points. So next, select right points of the small rectangle, and you can see this little dots. So if you don't see the dots, you can change the color of your layer. Make a double click on the layer and change the color, for example, to red. So I need these small dots. Click and drag. So that's fine. And make the same with the big rectangle. And now we need only these two points. Select both points and use your arrow keys of your keyboard and move it to the right. That's fine. Okay, I continue. The left side of the D. So this time I choose the Add Anchor Point tool and select the D and add a point here and move corner points to the left. Now I'll continue with the anchor point tool. Go to the line, to the path, and drag it like this. So you can at the handles. So please hold shift for vertical align. So if you like, you can move this point a little bit down. So next, I'm going to add new point. And the second point. And create a new point, or two points. And another point. Choose the anchor point tool and drag the lines. And with the direct selection tool, I'm going to move the lines again. So if you wish, you can change the stroke width, so open the stroke panel and change lines to very thin. So next, please delete this line. So choose the direct selection tool and select these two points and cut the points. And now delete this line. So we have to, if you select the line with the direct selection tool, press the delete button on your keyboard two times and delete these points again. So next, choose ellipse tool and create an ellipse, a circle, sorry. And now choose the group selection tool. And I'm going to move the circle. So click on this anchor point and move the circle to the other, to the rectangle. And the circle snap to the anchor point. And now choose again the direct selection tool. Click on this point and move this point and align it to the circle. So next, select both shapes, open the Pathfinder and click on this button, minus front. So I'd like to move the circle a little bit up. So I select only these points. Okay, we have two paths, and I'd like to make a compound path. So select the whole group, and now go to Object, Compound Path, and click on Make. That's fine. So next, I'm going to use the ellipse tool and create a circle. And now select both shapes and open the Pathfinder and click on minus front. So next, I'm going to delete this small corner. So select two points and cut the points and select only the small line and press two times the delete button. So next, select only this small points, choose the direct selection tool and drag this little dot. That's fine. So next I'm going to use the pencil tool. So make a double click. These are my options for the pencil tool. And I draw with the mouse some of these lines. Undo. Try a new line. So next, choose the direct selection tool and select only this point and drag this little dot. Okay, I'm done with the basic shape for the D and now it's time to fill it with color. So select the whole shape and apply stroke color, set the line stroke to inside, and I need 3 points for the stroke white, the same as the other letters. So next, going to expand it, go to objects and click expand appearance, or you can go to path and click on outline stroke. So next we need the inner path. So choose the group selection tool and we need three paths. So this inner path, next this and this. So copy the path, go to object, edit and click copy and paste it in a new, paste it in the same layer, go to edit and click on paste in place. So there are three new shapes. So please select these two shapes and now open the Pathfinder and click on this button, minus front. And next I'm going to make a compound path. And move the new compound path behind the other. So now choose eyedropper tool and select this shape, and with the eyedropper tool click on the letter O on the outside shape. Next I'm going to unlock letter O and make the lines invisible. Select the inside shape of the D and with the eyedropper tool click on the gold color of the O. So that's fine. So next I'm going to change the line of this gold, select the shape, choose a gradient tool and bring the fill color in foreground. Okay, next I'm going to copy the lines of the letter O. Select and copy. And paste it into the D layer. So now we need a shape, the inside shape, and make a copy. Make three copies, 1, 2, and 3. So we need the lines and one of the copies. So select line and one of the D copies and group it, or you can go to layers panel options and click on, oh sorry, you have to select both layers and collect it in new layer. So now I'm going to make a clipping mask. So it's very important to bring the D over the lines. And now deselect all and select the layer group and click on this button, make release clipping mask. So We have to uncheck the other copies of the D. So next, take this path and change the stroke non-color for fill and white color for stroke, and set the stroke to 2 points. And the last copy, so change the color. I use brown color for stroke and non-color for fill, and change the stroke width to 3 points, and move the shape 1 time right and down, and change the blending mode. Open the transparency panel, change the blending mode to multiply. That's fine. So next I'm going to create the shadow of the D. So I use the basic shape of my D. So first create a new layer and make a copy of this shape, and move the copy into the new layer. Arrange the layers and move the shadow group behind the D, and move the shadow layer 3 times right and 3 times down. So next I'm going to delete the inner path. And change the color. So I use the eyedropper tool and pick the color from the shadow of the O. So next, make a copy of this shape and move the copy 1 times up and left. Now select both layers and open the Pathfinder and click on minus front. That's it. Thanks for watching. If you liked this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, don't forget to subscribe. Hope to see you in the next video.